العالمين.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا، انه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم وبارك. ان شاء الله تعالى tonight, as usual, the weekly Sira class, Sira Halala. Just a quick thing that brother came to me yesterday and he's complaining about something that I don't know that we should talk about it or not. But anyway, this brother is a neighbor of the masjid and he is 5 times, mashallah, or as much as he can, he come to the masjid. And one of the brothers gave his contact information and his house number to our Tabligh brothers, Jazakumullah Khair, and they always go and lock his door. So he's not happy with this, because basically he's in the masjid. So get him in the masjid and that's it. But please pay attention to this. Don't give the contact information of anybody, because you know his house, to anybody else, because it's privacy and at the end of the day we live in Canada. So brothers, they get like annoyed and it gives you, you know, it makes it hard on us. Some people, they get misunderstand the idea. Like, you know, somebody's going to make da'wah, a great thing, but he's saying, you know what, I'm here in the masjid all the time. So please, Sheikh, remind the brother, please don't give my contact information to anybody. Jazakallah khairan. If they need me, I'm in the masjid, inshallah. I'm just delivering his message here.
I was going to say, you shouldn't be giving contact information for anybody, period.
Yes, absolutely.
Regardless of whether they're here or not.
Yeah.
Until you get their permission. So if you want to get their permission.
It's a very, very important thing that we have to recognize. Absolutely. I'm not picking on anybody. The brothers of the Tabligh, they're making great, great job. Inshallah, Jazakallah khair. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the reward for that. But, however, I can, as an imam, if you come to me now asking for, I have most of the brothers' contact information. If you come to me, I'm not going to give you his phone number until I check with him first. But please consider this, because some people, they don't like it. Last week, I was still talking about this important period of the da'wah that came to you and I as a piece of cake. Islam, we have it. We inherited Islam from our parent and we didn't do anything for it. But the Prophet ﷺ did a lot. Him and the great Sahaba, they did a lot. Last week we were talking about the suffering and the hard time that the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ went through to keep this da'wah going at that time in Mecca. And before that, for sure, we were talking about how hard time your Prophet, my Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to get the da'wah to you that way. So we're still with this period, the Meccan period. How many years, by the way, was the Meccan period? How many years did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spent in Mecca?
13.
No, he didn't spend, for sure, he didn't spend 13 years in Mecca. Did he spend 13 years in Mecca only?
7
years?
Eight.
13. Not 53? 53. He spent in Mecca 53 years. Guys, you have to make sure that you're focusing with me. But the...
You said the Prophet, he was only Prophet for 13 years in Mecca.
Yeah, but he himself spent in Mecca 53 years. As a Prophet, I didn't say as a Prophet. Okay? Fadr Habib.
The point is, there is a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَتَ تُعْتَبَرْ النُّبُوَّةِ
مِنَ الْمِيلَادِ وَلَا مِنَ الْرِسَالَةِ.
Yeah.
No, actually it was, it's a very simple thing, don't worry about it. Let's argue about this thing that you had when you go to the towers, last week. Okay, this is easy, inshallah. So the Prophet ﷺ spent of the time of da'wah 13 years in Mecca. And as we said, first they tried to make fun of him. didn't work. Verbally they abused him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, didn't work. Physically they abused him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, didn't work. They start abusing the companions of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I give examples last week, right? What are the examples that you give? You were here last week. What are the examples? Sayyidina Bilal, radiallahu anhu, who else? Sayyidina Ammar ibn Yasir, radiallahu anhu, who else? Yes, that's one of the main names that we mentioned last week. Sayyidina Khabbab ibn al-Ard, may Allah be pleased with all of them. And then it didn't work. Sayyidina Bilal, and we have the hadith that Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said that the first people, seven people to announce their Islam were the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Khadija radiallahu anha,
Ali
radiallahu anhu, Sayyidina Bilal, Sayyidina Suhaib, right? And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is one more. Sayyidina Miqdad radiallahu anhu. And he said Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud that all of them, they had people to protect them, except Sayyidina Bilal. Sayyidina Bilal was like, okay, he sacrificed his body totally for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they did what we mentioned and we talked about last week with them. Today, they're trying to work it in a different way. You know what? Harshness is not gonna work with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It seems that it's not gonna work with him. Today they're trying to negotiate the religion with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maybe he listens to us, he obeys us, maybe he gets easier with us. So let's negotiate. So they started actually negotiating the whole thing. Giving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam some gains, worldly gains, to make him quit the religion, or at least work it somehow between us and him, our religion and his religion. Let's see if it's gonna work. You know what? Or go to a different level, which is go to the main protection for him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and ask him to control him, his uncle Abu Talib, or yaqi, go challenge him. Show us. So they're trying, they will try, as we will explain today, to negotiate and to challenge the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to bring them some stuff to show that you are a Prophet, not for them to accept the Prophethood. Because if they want it, or accept a message, if they want to accept a message, they will do this like Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Salam. Who knows what Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Salam did? Anybody knows? Huh? Dr. Muhammad knows. So there was, we will have a specific session for Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Salam and Sayyidina Salman al-Farsi. They call them in history, in Sira, al-bahithani an al-haqiqa. Both of them, they were looking for the truth until they got it. Once they got the truth, they become Muslims right away. But Sayyidina, the story of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Salam, amazing. To show you how the Jewish people react with you and what they did at that time. But inshallah ta'ala, when we go together, move together, migrate together to Medina, we will mention the story of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Salam. But what they did? First, all the people of Mecca, they sit together and let's find somebody amongst us who is... فهمني ولا تجامل البريطانية وفضحك على الفيسبوك طيب مش كده ولا اقول لك جاي امبارح لاني شفتك خلاص حفظت دلع السلام عليك السلام ف let's go find somebody who is eloquent who can talk to Muhammad and give him the deal that we're thinking of. They went to whom? To mean Amin. لا first when they start negotiation, they went to Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, one of the main people that the Prophet ﷺ made dua against. Remember when we said that 2 weeks ago? He made dua against seven people. Mi li fakarun?
Abu Jahl.
Abu Jahl. Alayhi la'anatullah.
Abu Huraira.
Al-Mughira.
Al-Mughira.
Al-Mughira. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah wa Shaybah ibn Rabi'ah. والوليد بن المغيرة والوليد بن عتبة
أبو لهب أبو لهب
لا ما دعاش على أبو لهب no was not one of them. أبو لهب didn't go أصلا for the battle of أحد battle of Badr because all of them they passed they got killed in the battle of Badr. طيب that's an assignment. Okay, Google it. أمية بن خلف. مين بقى؟ تاني. عقبة بن أبي معيط. Right? وآخر واحد كان مين؟ الوليد بن عتبة. Seven people. ولا طيب خلاص هم دول seven people. No assignment. No one missing? You count how many? Okay, خلاص. We'll get them later, inshallah. فأرسلوا إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عتبة بن ربيعة to negotiate. They sent عتبة to negotiate with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. If you're selling, if you're ready to sell your ethics and principles for money or for position, or for any worldly gains, you have no principles. For period. يعني if somebody comes to you and say, you know what, how much you want to quit or to abandon or to leave Islam, and you're even thinking about it, you don't have that. You don't have that concept in your heart, أصلا. You don't have that great thing in your heart. But they don't know. They tried what the Prophet ﷺ. Let's see what عتبة بن ربيعة offered the Prophet ﷺ. First, he blamed him. قال له يا ابني انت جيت خربت بيتنا. Simply. قال له كده يا يعني you came and you destroyed the whole community. Now the people are like, you know, the children are enemies to the father of their parents. The families are apart because of you. So he's blaming him. The guy's lying. The guy's so smart. Yeah, I come to you, Sheikh, you know what, that khutbah that you said this morning was like very, you know, depressing. And you know what, there are two brothers, they were fighting after the khutbah. You didn't talk about the khutbah yet. But you made me feel like, you know what happened? There is something wrong. So I have to reconsider what I've talked about. What did he say? Wrong to say that. So he started with the Prophet ﷺ this way, and then he gave him these. If I'm doing something wrong, why you're offering me all of this? فيقول كما جاء في الحديث الصحيح جاء okay أرسل كفار مكة عتبة بن ربيعة ليعرض على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما قد رآه حلا للمشكلة. فقال يا ابن أخي إنك منا حيث قد علمت من المكان في النسب. برضو دي this is an Egyptian way. Egyptian way بتثبت الزبون. طبعا some people they don't know what I'm saying. Only the Egyptian people now they understand. تثبت الزبون. You go to somebody, you want to get something from him. Brother, you're the best. What? Everybody said that you are the best. خلاص. What do you need, brother? I need this. خلاص. We do it in fundraising, by the way. JazakAllah khair. You did a great job here. And then another said the zubun. He was a customer who signed right away. Okay, so he said to him, you know your position in Mecca. You're from a noble family. My dear nephew, you know your position. منا من نسب. وقد أتيت قومك بأمر عظيم. You came with a great thing. فرقت به. بدأ يلومه. He started blaming him. فرقت به جماعته. فاسمع مني أعرض عليك أمورا لعلك تقبل بعضها. So listen for me. You what you came with, you know what? It's a great thing, but it's a problematic thing that it creates this division in the community. So listen to me. I'm here to negotiate. I'm not here to say that you're wrong. I'm here to negotiate the whole thing with you. طيب عاوز يبقى عتبة بن ربيعة. إن كنت إنما تريد بهذا الأمر مالا جمعنا لك من أموالنا حتى تكون أكثرنا مالا. So عتبة بن ربيعة is talking to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم who didn't care about money أصلا before the message or after the message, who left the whole world with nothing صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he's saying, if you are looking for money, we can collect from all of us until we make you the richest. يعني حتى إن الكاتب هنا بيعلق عليها ظنوا أن الدعوة تباع بالمال والمنصب. يعني والذي يترك دعوته من أجل منصب ومال داعية فاشل الرصب. يعني this is might be for us. يعني if you're taking the دعوة as a volunteer, حتى volunteer position or a job, and you're willing to leave it for a position, sorry to say that you're a failure. You didn't do it. You are not getting the message أصلا. وإن كنت تريد شرفا, sit down. وإن كنت تريد شرفا سودناك علينا. So if you need to be the head of Quraysh, you are the head of Quraysh. طب مو crazy. يعني if you're willing to give him all of that, طيب, then you know that he's strong and his da'wah is strong and he's not gonna leave it anyway. But they're trying. وإن كنت تريد ملكا ملكناك علينا وإن كان الذي يأتيك رئيا تراه لا تستطيع رده عن نفسك أي مسا من الجن طلبنا لك الطب وبدلنا في فيه أموالنا حتى تبرأ. Even you're sick, if you feel that you're sick and some jinn touches you, like the jinn that touches a lot of people these days, they don't know what's going on. Wallahi, the people leave the jinn to take advantage of them. And they come to the sheikh, they think that the sheikh deals with the jinn. حول الله قوة إلا بالله. I'm scared. I'm the first one to get scared from these things. Anyway, if you think that that's you're touched by jinn, we'll help you. We'll get you somebody to help you. And we'll pay for that. طب the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he waited until عتبة بن ربيعة to finish his nice speech. فقال له فرغت. You know when you listen to somebody and at the end, no matter what he's going to say, you say no. يعني you're talking to your doctor at the university and he's not convinced with what you're preparing or presenting to him and he's yeah, yeah, yeah. And then for 1 hour you're talking and then he said, you know, sorry, look at your feeling. But it was not this. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah was one of the people of Makkah, and I mentioned that last week, maybe last week or the week before last week, was one of the few people in Makkah who understand that this man will not get something wrong. He knows him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told them, just leave him alone. If he is gonna get victory over us, he is one of us. And if the Arab people will defeat him, خلاص, they did it for you. But they didn't listen to him. But look what happened. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he read from the beginning of Surah Fussilat. What's the first ayah of Surah Fussilat? Huh? Is it Hamim? طيب. Hamim until he went to this ayah. فإن كما يقول الله تبارك وتعالى فإن أعرضوا فقل أنذرتكم صاعقة مثل صاعقة عاد وثمود. This man got this from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he got so scared. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam read this few ayat from Surah Fussilat ending with this ayah, and they turn away, those people, the people of Mecca, tell them that I'm warning you against a thunderbolt like the thunderbolt that struck Ad and Thamud. He left him and he went home. What happened? Utbah ibn Rabi'ah stayed home and he didn't go out. They're waiting for him in Dar al-Nadwa, in their place, to give them the report that he's Muhammad is willing to negotiate. He left, he got so scared, he went home, stayed home. Who is the key figure and the key person, as we agreed before, in Mecca at that time, from the Mushrikeen side? Abu Jahl. We said that as Abu Jahl, let's agree on that. So Abu Jahl is asking about him, where is Utbah? So didn't he right away his like mind went to the idea that, you know what, he got deceived by Muhammad right away. If he doesn't come back to us with good news that he's willing to negotiate, meaning that he got deceived by him. He fooled him. Muhammad fooled him. Saba ila Muhammad. He's thinking. And by the way, the man was almost there. He's almost there to be a Muslim, but his ego prevented him from accepting Islam. He knows that, subhanAllah. Like what happened with the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يعني what did the people of Quraysh will say about me? So, فقال أبو جهل والله يا معشر قريش ما نرى عتبة إلا صبا إلى محمد. He's talking to the people, sometimes you have these people, the people of fitna. You know what? He said that, I know that he is meaning you. In his speech, he was talking about you. يا أخي والله ما كان بيتكلم عليه. He didn't mean that. You know what? خلاص. فهيج الناس. He got everybody out. You know what? عُصبته صبا إلى محمد. He listened to Muhammad and he got deceived by Muhammad and he didn't come back to us. Let's go to him. See what happened with him. وأعجبه كلامه وما ذاك إلا من حاجة أصابت. انطلقوا بنا إليه فأتوه فقال أبو جهل والله يا عتبة ما جئنا إلا أنك صبوت إلى محمد وأعجبك أمره فإن كان بك حاجة جمعنا لك من أموالنا ما يغنيك وأقسم بالله لا يكلم محمدا وأقسم بالله لا يكلم محمدا أبدا وقال لقد علمت أني. So first thing he went to him, you know what? We know that he deceived you. He fooled you. But hold on, come here. We don't want to lose you too. So if you're thinking about money, I'll give you money. He's talking to the one of the richest people of Mecca. Well, that's the touchy thing, the tangible thing that they have. It's money and power at that time, nothing else. They don't think about the religion at all. Faisal offering Utba himself, like, we'll give you something. He told them, what are you talking? Man, what are you talking about? Yesterday, last night, and that's why I didn't come for Fajr. It's not a reason, but alhamdulillah. There was a problem between two Egyptians. حلو المعلومة دي. حلو المعلومة Egyptians. عشان الجديد. جمال بقول لك الجديد. They were traveling both today, so I had to go fix it. We spent like حتى مطلع الفجر fixing the problem. So one of them on money, يعني brothers, they, it's not a big deal, but anyway, one of them said that you're talking to me. Basically, the problem was about $70. To be honest with you. Okay, $70. And he's asking for money. He says, you're talking to a millionaire about money? يا أخي حرام عليك. أنت جايبنا أنا. ونضيع وقتي عشان $70 وتقول لي مليونير مليونير. What are you talking about? So he says, you're talking to a millionaire. You're a millionaire and you're getting me for $70, spend 3-4 hours. And then you know that Imam hour is $300. You know that? Okay. Alhamdulillah. يلا, keep counting. Time 5 times a day, prayer. The thing is, they thought about it. They thought that Abu Utbah ibn Rabi'ah will have the same, that same thing. He pushed him away. He said that it's not about this. And then he told them that what happened, that he read that Quran to me, and I know that it's not his words. I'm sure that it's not his words. لَيْسَ مِنْ كَلَامِهِ مَا هُوَ بِسِحْ وَلَا بِشِعْ وَلَا كَهَانَ. It's not just magic or fortune telling, or it is real thing. And he start يعني saying the ayat from Surah Fussil. Number one, plan didn't work out. This guy is not going to listen, he's not going to negotiate his religion with us, or his religion with us. You know, they went to the second way of negotiation is they start accepting Islam as a religion. خلاص, الواقع فرض نفسه. The reality is that he's there, his people are practicing the religion, they're following, so let's work it around us. يعني بيقولوا عليها التقارب بين الأديان. ما عرفش ازاي دي, بس هي كده. ومش هيترجمها طبعا عشان ما اعرفش ده. They say, you know what, they went to the Prophet ﷺ with a different deen. You know, Muhammad, hold on. We know that you love your religion, you want to practice your religion. And by the way, it was a good deal at that time. Look at the situation of the Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba al-Kiram in Mecca, and the situation of the people of Mecca. They're very strong and very influential, and he's weak, and his people are weak. And they're coming with this offer. What is it? أن تعبد آلهتنا اللات والعزى سنة ونعبد إلهك سنة. The Prophet ﷺ, by the way, didn't give the answer. He kept quiet. So the offer now is, we are considering and recognizing your religion. However, we cannot leave our religion. So let's do it this way, that you worship our God, our gods, for 1 year, Allah, wal-Uzza, and whatever, for 1 year, and we worship your God for 1 year. 1 year, 1 year, 1 year, 1 year. Then the Prophet ﷺ kept quiet. It was a good, not a good offer, but considering the circumstances surrounding Muslims in Mecca, it's good. It's a good achievement. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala غالبٌ ودين الله تبارك وتعالى غالب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala حكم بذلك ألا يعبد سواه. It's only, the whole message is about لا إله إلا الله, right? So it's all about not about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody is worthy to be worshipped with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How come we agree on that? Right away, Prophet ﷺ kept quiet. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down قوله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. Now we cannot do that deal. It's not gonna work with us. You have your religion, I have my religion. And by the way, again, this is not a kind of recognizing others or somebody who is worshipping the cow, and you tell him, you know what, you have your religion, I have my religion. It's not this. I respect him. Don't get me wrong. I respect him as a human being. He is my friend. He is my neighbor. He is. We share the same place, the same work, the same country. Absolutely fine. We respect them. But I cannot go to somebody and tell him, you know what, you have your religion, I respect your religion. No, there's no religion here. Inna dina inda Allahi, that's what I know. I don't know anything else. He knows something else, I respect that for him. But me, I don't know it. All what I know is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ali Imran, inna dina inda Allahi al-Islam. That's the same religion that Musa came with, Isa came with, Ibrahim came with, alayhi salam, Adam alayhi salam came with. The same one religion. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the Surah Al-Kafirun, say, oh, you disbelievers, يعني, you don't worship what I worship, I don't worship what you worship, you have your religion, I have my religion. Simple. Didn't work. لم تفلح هذه المحاولة. انتقلوا إلى مرحلة تحدث عنها القرآن كثير. وهي المحاولة التحدي بشيء وهم يعني هو مش طالب معجزة حتى يؤمن. He's not asking for a miracle for him to understand or to accept a religion. No. He is asking, or he is challenging the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know what? Get us this. حتى حدثت كل هذه الأمور وبرضه لم يؤمن. ولذلك يقول الله تبارك وتعالى: وقالوا لولا أنزل عليه آيات من ربي قل إنما الآيات عند الله وإنما أنا نذير مبين. And then they start asking for وقالوا لن نؤمن لك حتى تفجر لنا من الأرض. We start asking for this miracles here and there, here and there, here and there. سيدنا أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه يقول في هذا الإطار: سأل أهل مكة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. So سيدنا أنس saying, you know what, the people of Mecca asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to bring them a miracle. طب يا أخي, think with me. وإحنا قلنا, don't think that if you were at that time, that's something that we mentioned last week clearly. يعني, let me ask the question again because I know that some brother, they were not here last week. If you have that, يعني, somebody's asking, do you wish to live at that time, the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم or not? What's going to be the answer? Of course, not. Of course, yes, right? So what about from the seerah that there were many of the smart people that they didn't accept Islam? And they were kuffar? And they died as kuffar? Minhum Abu Jahl himself, by the way. Abu Jahl was a very generous man with the meaning of man, but he didn't. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the idea. That's why the ulama, they said that Islam do not wish, but think of the circumstances. You might be not, you might, يعني, it might not be the case as you think. that you're going to be next to the Prophet ﷺ all the time, and will you go through the hardship or not? Will you pass that hardship or not? Because the Sahaba, they went through a severe hardship while, especially in the first period of Islam. So they say, you know what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that it's better for you to be in that generation. It's better for you. It's easier for you. And inshallah ta'ala, easier for all of us. Anyway, so imagine that they're asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give them ayah. We need an ayah. And they see the moon, two parts. What else do you need? وَلَمْ يُؤْمِنْ سَيْنَا أَنَسْ يَقُولْ سَأَلَ أَهْلُ مَكَّةَ النَّبِيَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ آيَةً فَأَرَاهُمُ الْقَمَرْ أَوْ انْشِقَاقِ الْقَمَرْ فَنَزَلَتْ قَالَ اللَّهِ تبارك وتعالى اقتربت الساعة انشق القمر ومع ذلك لم يؤمن. They saw the moon in two parts split and they didn't believe in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعن جبير بن مطعم رضي الله عنه قال انشق القمر على عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فصار فرقتين، فرقة على هذا الجبل وفرقة على هذا الجبل، فقالوا the people of Quraysh فقالوا سحرنا محمد. So imagine, we need an ayah. Here is the ayah. The قمر is two parts, one part here on this mountain, one part here is in other mountain. It's not that the cloud is dividing the moon. No, it's one, two parts. Then they said, Muhammad, يعني سحرنا.
Bewitched us.
Bewitched us. يعني he brought a magic. He's not, again, they're not winning. He just challenging you. Like some people, by the way. This is not the same thing, but some people, they do it with us. It's very common. Your brother come to you, no, Sheikh, you know what? What do you think about this? What is the ruling on 1, 2, 3, 4? Give him your answer. You know what? I heard Sheikh so-and-so say what? And Sheikh so-and-so said what? And Sheikh so-and-so. So he's testing you at the end of the day. It's fine. No problem. He doesn't want to get the knowledge because he got it from different source, which is fine, absolutely fine. But again, they're not willing to accept that from the Prophet ﷺ. All what they're doing is to they're putting him under that challenge. ولذلك من الأشياء التي طلبوها وسأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الله تبارك وتعالى ذلك. يقول سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما قالت قريش للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ادع لنا ربك يصبح لنا الصفا ذهبا ونؤمن بك يا ولد العفريت. They're willing, they want to believe in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And their condition is we need a safa. Who knows what a safa? What is a safa?
Mountain,
right? بين الصفا والمروة. إن الصفا والمروة من شعائر الله. Right? So they told the Prophet ﷺ, ask your Lord to make a safa gold for us. A mountain of gold, majani. Crazy. And then we will believe in you. Then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala knows what's in their heart. Yani, do you think it's hard on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make a safa gold or diamond? It will be right away. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قل نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فدعا. Then the Prophet ﷺ made the dua, by the way. He wants his people to be, يعني, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He cares for them. فدعا ربه فنزل جبريل عليه السلام. فقال يا محمد إن ربك يقرئك السلام. ويقول لك إن شئت أصبح الصفا ذهبا. لهم ذهبا. فمن كفر منهم بعد ذلك أعذبه عذابا لا أعذبه أحدا من العالمين. وإن شئت فتحت لهم باب الرحمة والتوبة. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم بل باب الرحمة والتوبة. So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in their heart. Prophet ﷺ made the dua. Jibreel alayhi salam came down and he says, Muhammad, your people are asking for this. So okay, we'll do it for them. We'll transfer the whole or change the whole mountain from sand to be gold. But if any of them disbelieves in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will punish them and I will have them they will have a torment and a punishment that nobody else got. لا أعذب أحد من العالمين. Severe or more severe than anybody else. Or no gold but always the gate of repentance and mercy is open for them. Prophet ﷺ knows. Yani don't you? Some people, they think when you live in a Muslim country, you're the most pious person, right? People still think that. Some people, they think that if you live in Mecca, for example, you are the best, and you get shocked. And some people who are manufacturing wine in Saudi Arabia, in some places, right? Have you read about this? Stuff like that. I'm not saying that they're bad people over there, but wherever you are, it's going to be good and bad people. So people will disbelieve for sure. But when the gate and the mercy is there and the repentance is acceptable for us, it's even better. It's for sure it's better for us. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, "Bal babu tawbati wa rahma." That's what, this is better for them. I know that it's better for them that you commit the sin and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts your repentance. 5 more minutes. Inshallah we'll conclude. بطريقة خلصت. مشكلة. طيب. رابعاً, this is the last. واسمع دي بقى. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم got the biggest support from Abu Talib. Believe it or not, Abu Talib died as a non-Muslim, right? Some people, they don't accept this fact, by the way. Some Muslims, they don't accept this fact. Now, because he is the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ, we shouldn't say that about him. No, he died as a non-Muslim. Up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of the day, but he was not Muslim. He didn't accept Islam. He came in the authentic hadith that at the last moment of his life, Ya Am, say La ilaha illallah. He didn't say it, man. He didn't say it. Innaka la tahdi man ahbabt. You don't give guidance to whomsoever you love. It's up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, so they said, you know what? Number one, plan. Two, three didn't work. Let's go to Abu Talib. We have to practice pressure through Abu Talib. On Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they went to Abu Talib. Ya Abu Talib. إِنَّ ابْنَ أَخِيكَ هَذَا قَدْ أَذَانَ. برضو نفس الاستراتيجي. The same strategy. They want him to feel bad. They want him to blame himself for something that his nephew is doing. إِنَّ ابْنَ أَخِيكَ قَدْ أَذَانَ فِي نَدِينَ وَمَسْجِدِنَا فَنْهَهُ عَنَّا يَا أَخِي. Your nephew has bothered and harmed us in our place of gathering, the nadi بتاعه, and in our place of worship, al-Kaaba. So please, ask him to stop. That's too much. And we know what happened when the Prophet ﷺ was praying around al-Kaaba, and Abu Jahl has a situation, and Umayyah ibn Khalaf, I think Uqbah ibn Abi Mu'ayl, has a situation. Both of them, they tried to harm the Prophet ﷺ physically when he was praying around al-Kaaba. So they didn't, they didn't like it. فَقَالَ أَبُو طَالِبْ لِبْنِهِ عَقِيلٍ انطلق فأتني بمحمد. Go and get, or fetch. Fetch أحسن, صح؟